Hey, everybody.
That was recorded, huh? Okay.
Hey, everybody. Thanks for joining. We've got a bunch of different things going on, so stick with us. We're going to share them with you right now. So, you know, if you haven't, please like, subscribe, hit the bell. You know, it would be nice. Anyway, on to the important stuff. So we've been talking about our aerogardens, right? We kind of got back into it after the big move and the big life change and all that kind of stuff. And I remember that we had some video of the unpacking of our first aerogarden, which is called the Harvest model. And so, you know, if you are watching, we unpacked it. Even our sweet Millie helped us.
Millie.
Yeah. And it was really neat. And, you know, I've actually had some people say, well, what exactly do you mean by hydroponic? Like, what are you doing? So it's
first of all, they assume we're talking about weed first, but we're not. We're growing tomatoes and herbs and peppers for the most part.
Yeah. Cause FYI, it's legal in this state. So, it was real straightforward. I remember, you know, I mean, you followed the directions. You did like all the work.
It's easy.
Yeah, it's really easy. You know, you pull it out, you put it together. I mean, it was very minimal assembly. You know, mm-hmm. You have the light on there, the adjustable LED light, and you know, the first one we got, I think, it was just tomatoes.
The
mini cherry tomatoes.
Yeah.
You know, it came with the pods and. It came with the liquid food, and we just followed directions, and we set it up, and we got a ton of tomatoes, mm-hmm. like in a month or so. So anyway, we just wanted to share with you, you know, it's really straightforward, and it's hydroponic gardening, which is just water and liquid food.
You just have to water it, mm-hmm. and it reminds you, these models remind you if the water's too low, mm-hmm. because sometimes it's easy to, like,
forget.
Yeah. And it reminds you to feed them, so you add liquid food every 2 weeks. It flashes and reminds you to do that. And other than that, it's, you know, pretty much set it and forget it. Yeah. You do have to pollinate the flowers if you want fruit, which we do. You have to prune it, or it's recommended that you prune it. The first one, I just kind of let go wild. It was in a room with a lot of sun anyway, so I just kind of like let it keep growing around the grow lights, which was an interesting experiment. It did well, but it's not really designed to stay that big. This tomato plant, I'm going to try to keep it more compact and see how it does.
Yeah, our first attempt, and we got a lot of tomatoes.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, we really did, but man, we had plant growth everywhere, and we were using jute core, and we were trying to keep it all together, but not this.
It worked, but I don't want to deal with that again. So
speaking of our current growth, you know, we've been sharing with you our excitement. Oh my gosh, look at this. This is, 60 days, 62 days?
I don't know. I need to go look. Yeah. I think it's been about 6 or 8 weeks since we started it.
Look, we have tomatoes coming in. And
lots of tomatoes coming in. And lots of flowers, so lots of potential other tomatoes coming in. It's awesome. It's looking really, really good. We have basil coming out of our ears. We had that dud pod that we placed an order with aerogarden, and it took us a while to actually do it because you had to enter the model number, which is on the bottom of the unit, and the lot number of the seed pod. It took us a minute to realize that was printed on the top of the thing. And then at the end of all of it, we got a okay, thanks for your submission, but we didn't get a confirmation email, we didn't get any indication that it was accepted and shipped. And then in the mail, like a week later or a week and a half later, we got a new seed pod in the mail. So we plugged it in.
Great customer support. Seriously, great customer support.
So we plugged that in and now it's sprouting. So in addition to all of our other basils that are keeping everything tasting very good around here, we have another plant popping up.
So some of the basil that we have basil.
And then we have like three varieties of basil. I don't know how else. They have different names, but they
taste
exactly
the same. Purple
basil,
which looks beautiful, but tastes the same as basil.
Yeah, yeah.
And then we have Thai basil,
which
that has a different flavor. And then we have lemon basil.
Which is also awesome.
Man, it's so tasty. So and then this new one, the dud.
Salads are, that's one of the basil ones, I think.
Oh, it is?
I think so.
It's called Napolitano, but.
Yeah, I think it's going to taste like the other two.
All right, salads have been awesome.
Salads have been great. Pizzas have been great. Yeah. Very excited about that.
So much basil, we made pesto.
And we had a pizza's worth of pesto.
Yeah. Yeah, that was awesome. Good. And then our chili plants.
They're getting there.
We've got some little buds. So I think they're going to flower and hopefully you can be the bee and pollinate.
That one has been slower. Those were seeds that we planted ourselves. They weren't aerogarden pods and they have definitely taken a longer time to take off.
But it still works.
But yeah. So.
And you know, if you've done that, if you have an aerogarden, you've used your own seed in the pods, aerogarden, let us know how your experience has been because these have taken much longer. And we're kind of concerned too because they're a larger kind of plant.
We've done these before. We've done both of these varieties before.
Anyway, so stay tuned. We're going to have some tomatoes and some peppers to share pretty soon. Yep. So that was kind of it for the aerogarden. We are signed up to run that 5K in Santa Fe, New Mexico in 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
2 weeks. So we've been training.
We've been running. I wouldn't call it training. We've been running a couple times.
Well, it's either sit on my ass or run, so I'm training.
We're not following a plan. No, we're just trying to go running. We kind of set out this week to try to run every day.
Yeah.
With the caveat of if work gets too weird, we won't.
Yeah.
Beat ourselves up and work
it
got
did.
Weird.
It did.
So we made it out on Monday to the fitness center. And then we made it out on Friday to the fitness center and we ran on the treadmills both of those
days. We did make
it
out on Wednesday to the fitness center. No, Tuesday. When was it?
Saturday
to the fitness center and it was full. So we made it, but we weren't able to get on the treadmills.
I don't know, whatever. One other day we tried.
So we tried three times. But we're doing okay because we ran 2.5 miles, I think, almost every time, which is pretty good.
Wait, how many? What did you say?
2.5 miles?
No.
I ran 2.5 miles.
Okay. I didn't. Not even close.
Well, you should have just gone with it.
we ran 20 minutes, which was like a mile and a half.
No, on the other day, I ran.
That was last weekend, I think.
Yeah. So anyway, we're running. We're going to run 3 miles, so we're almost there. I pulled a muscle again. So
it hasn't really healed. It just keeps re-flaring. So
yeah,
we have a doctor's appointment soon.
Yeah, that's not fun. It's kind of weird living out here in this middle of nowhere, beautiful area. Getting medical treatment is a hassle.
It takes some effort.
Yeah, it takes a hassle. So, or it is a hassle. So my doctor's appointment is, 10 hours away?
It's more than that.
It's
right?
Like 12 hours away, right?
14, I don't know.
We're gonna go see my doctor who is like 14 hours away. So anyway, hey, if you care, I'll let you know how that goes. That's pretty good. So we signed up for that. And then we did something really awesome. We booked.
Yesterday.
Yes.
When I woke up, I was just kind of like feeling a little irky. And I thought, you know what? I'm not going to touch social media today.
Oh, yeah.
So I kind of sat back and I didn't. I picked up my phone very little throughout the day. Mm-hmm. And what that meant was we had a lot of time to do other stuff.
Yeah.
So on our Power Saturday, we booked our DVC room for the Run Disney Springtime Surprise 2025 race weekend. We're going to plan to run that 10 miler. So we have our room booked.
Yay!
I did some sewing. Ooh. I'm working on 3 flannel shirts for David in tandem right now. It's like an assembly line situation. Yeah. So I got all the sleeves on all of those and all the side seams and all of those. We're getting closer.
Psyched. I can't ever find a shirt that has a long enough sleeve.
Poor Davey, my tolly.
But
I'm making them. I finished a puzzle that I've been working on. David practiced the guitar and learned a new song. I practiced the piano. We baked a loaf of bread. David
Delicious.
Made pancakes for breakfast.
Oh my gosh.
We made 2 other meals.
We hung up our instruments.
We cleaned up this whole area over here, which involved taking instruments out of our ukuleles, out of our little like bins we had them in over here and putting them on the wall. We just bought a vintage couch that's going to go over here. So we need to clear some space, but it looks really, really great right now.
Yeah.
We hung some shelves in the pantry and tidied up the pantry.
You know, seriously.
It was amazing how much we got done yesterday.
Instead of being glued to our phones, it's like, oh man, let's do something. Yeah. We had a power Saturday.
Yeah, and that was all before like 2 p.m. I think 2 p.m. was when we finally decided to have a beer and like sit down and watch some TV. But yeah, it was a really, really productive day.
Some life updates. And it felt really good, you know, because sometimes... Yeah. I don't know. Again, if you don't know, we moved away from a place that we had lived. You know, I had been there for 30 years.
Our whole adulthood.
Yeah, and we moved away, and it's like we're really kind of in the middle of nowhere. And so it's been kind of, it's been hard. It's been fun. It's beautiful. We love it. But I was just, I don't know, kind of feeling kind of weird. And yesterday, doing all that, I feel like refreshed and re-energized. Mm-hmm. And it was really, really nice. Instead of just kind of being plugged, and maybe we're plugged in because... It's like nobody around. I don't know, but it was really, really cool. So we thought we'd share some updates with you. It was really nice, feeling pretty good, and we also have been trying to eat better. you know, not running regularly the way we have been for years,
or walking a dog,
or walking Millie.
Any of that?
Yeah, I'm putting on some weight, and I'm feeling kind of. Icky.
Clothes aren't fitting me.
Yeah. So we have been like, you know, cooking at home and making our own stuff. And
this also happened at the same time we happened to take a look at a, you know, credit card spending review. You know how they kind of break things down into categories.
Who looks at those?
Give you a nice little pie chart. Well, we had a disproportionately large segment to eating out.
It was like two pieces of pie. One was 90% eating out, and the rest was.
So, we're also saving money, and we're trying to eat better. So yesterday we had three really good meals at home. Yeah. One of them was pancakes. But here's something we discovered.
Hey, come on, pancakes. It's just flour and water.
Did you know that you can take pancake batter and just put it in the fridge and eat it the next day? You don't have to make the whole batch like we've always done.
So instead of eating 20 pancakes in one day.
So we had pancakes this morning.
But
too.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say we have been eating really well because we've been eating at home, cooking for ourselves.
Yeah.
So that I think we're feeling better in that regard too.
And
here's the deal. We already have planned trips to go to Disneyland this year, possibly twice.
Definitely twice.
Yeah. But also, we are planning to yet again participate in Dapper Day.
Oh, you're breaking that news. Yeah. So we realized that Dapper Day at Disneyland, the fall Dapper Day, falls almost exactly between David's birthday and our anniversary. One of our many. But it's right in the middle of those two. So we were already kind of planning a trip for David's birthday because we splurged and bought the annual passes this year. Right. So we're going to be taking several trips to Disneyland probably.
Yep.
But I figured, hey, because this anniversary is the one where we got married at Disneyland. So when we can, we like to spend that anniversary at Disneyland because it's a lot of fun. So this will be perfect. And it's Dapper Day.
So, now we did Dapper Day once before. Matter of fact, let me share a couple of pictures the beautiful stuff that Laura made for us for Dapper Day. And she already knows. She already knows.
We know what we're going to do. It was a joint idea.
But it's a surprise. It's a surprise.
But we did some market research yesterday. Oh, yeah. We watched one of the movies associated with the franchise.
It's going to be awesome. It's going to be awesome.
Considering.
So
we'll document that when we get closer.
Oh, yeah, of course. And I can't wait to. Anyway,
it's going
to
be so great.
It's going to be great.
Yeah.
So those are our updates. Thanks so much for watching. I don't know. I think we're kind of like finding a new rhythm, and it's kind of neat. In 2 weeks, we'll take you along on our run in Santa Fe, New Mexico, and we'll just keep sharing, and I hope you keep sharing with us. We love the comments. Thank you so much. And also, we're planning yet another chocolate tasting video with the remainder of UK chocolate that we have no comparable chocolate here to compare
tasting.
To. But yeah, I hope you tune in for that. Always an adventure with you. We will see you soon.